This is the story about the God who loves us in the Bible. We find truth and purpose to love God and love others. We're searching God's word for things to discover. Is alive.
Apostles, and this happened 40 whole days after he came back from the dead. The story tells that Jesus went to heaven and he's now sitting right next to God on the right side. Jesus did go to heaven, but he didn't leave us alone. He sent us a close friend, the Holy Spirit. And whilst we wait for him to come back to earth, we have to share the good news about him with everyone we can. We are never, ever, ever alone because God's Spirit lives inside us if we follow Jesus. The Holy Spirit is our helper. It guides us and it listens to us when we have problems and it helps us learn from God. So enjoy today's lesson about the ascension of Jesus.
Okay, we're going to listen to a Bible story today, and it's about the ascension. And that's when Jesus returned to heaven. So after Jesus died and he rose from the dead, he spent 40 days on earth. We went to go visit people and he saw all his friends and all his followers. And then after 40 days, he ascended into heaven. Do you know what the word ascend means?
Go up.
Going up. So Jesus ascended into heaven, and that's what we're going to watch today. So what does the word ascension mean?
Ascension, you go up.
To go up. Who went up?
Jesus.
Can you show me where up is? That's it.
Like going to the roof.
Even further than the roof.
Going to heaven.
That's it. He went to heaven. And what's really cool is even though Jesus left and Jesus went to heaven, he didn't leave his disciples alone. He sent something. Here's a picture of our story today, and I've got a verse on it, and it says Acts chapter 1 verse 11. Jesus has been taken from you into heaven, but someday he will return from heaven in the same way you saw him go. So just like he went up to heaven, one day he's going to come back. Which is
but going down.
The opposite.
Into the clouds. It was time for Jesus to go to heaven. He led his disciples to the top of a mountain near Jerusalem. "Here's what I want you to do," he said. "Wait in Jerusalem until you receive the promised Holy Spirit. Then tell everyone about me. Go from Jerusalem to Judea to Samaria and then to the rest of the world." "Make many disciples. Baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Teach them everything you learned from me. I will always be with you." When he had said this, Jesus rose into the sky. Up he went until he disappeared into a cloud. His disciples watched him. They stood there, staring into the sky. Two men dressed in white appeared. "Jesus has gone to heaven," they explained. "He will come back in the same way." So the disciples obeyed Jesus and went to Jerusalem.
God's story after the tomb. So part of God's story is about what happened in the 40 days after Jesus came back to life. And it goes like this. Remember when Jesus came to earth, healed people, taught people about the kingdom of God, and then died for the punishment we deserve? And then how he came back to life? It's all true. That really happened. But it took some time for Jesus' followers to hear this good news. Like two men who were walking together to a place called Emmaus. It was the same day that Jesus' tomb had been found empty, but they didn't know this. All they knew was Jesus had just died, and they were sad and confused because they had thought he would save their people and change everything. And they were scared because they had no idea what to expect now that he was gone. They had heard that some people went to Jesus' tomb, but he wasn't in it. Instead, there were angels, and they told them, "He's not here. He is risen." But these were all still just stories to the two men. As they walked and talked, another man appeared and began walking beside them. It was Jesus, but they didn't recognize him. The man asked them what they were talking about. They couldn't believe this stranger didn't know what had just happened in Jerusalem. It was the biggest news in the land. So they told this man about Jesus, how he'd been a great teacher and prophet, how he had healed people, but then was arrested and killed. They walked and talked with Jesus for the rest of the day, still not recognizing that they were talking to Jesus. In fact, it wasn't until dinner until they realized it was him. And as soon as they did, Jesus was gone, just disappeared. The two men didn't waste any time getting back to Jerusalem to tell their friends what had happened. They found them hiding with all the doors locked and the windows shut tight. See, after Jesus was killed, it was dangerous to be known as his disciple, so they were scared. But the two men told them that the rumors were true. Jesus had risen, and they had seen him, talked to him, and eaten with him. And as they were telling this story, Jesus appeared to the disciples again. Even though the doors and windows were locked, maybe they thought they were seeing a ghost. Maybe some of them weren't even sure it was him. But Jesus knew their doubts and told them, "See my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." This was the same Jesus they knew, the same Jesus they had watched teach crowds and heal people. He was real, not a ghost, not a dream. It was Jesus, and he was right there with them. But this wasn't the last time Jesus would appear to his friends. Later, Peter and some of the other disciples went to the Sea of Galilee. They stayed up all night long fishing, but didn't catch a single thing. In the morning, a man called to them from shore. "Do you have any fish?" Now, this was Jesus, but just like before, the disciples didn't recognize him. When they told this stranger that no, in fact, they hadn't caught any fish at all, he told them, "Throw your net on the right side of the boat and you will find some." They did as he said, and immediately the net was completely full of fish. Right then, one of the disciples in the boat, John, knew that he was seeing Jesus. Peter jumped in the water and got to shore as fast as he could. When he got there, there was a fire with bread and fish on hot coals. There, the disciples and Jesus ate breakfast together, just like they had before. And they all knew, without a doubt, that this was Jesus. After this, Jesus appeared to over 500 people. And later, the Bible says Jesus was taken up into heaven. But just because Jesus wasn't on earth with his friends didn't mean they were alone. Jesus had told them he would leave, but he also said he would send the Holy Spirit to be with them, and that one day he will come back and make everything new. And that's the story of what happened after the tomb. So in case you missed it, here's a quick version. Jesus died. He came back to life. He spent time with his friends. He was taken up into heaven. He sent his Holy Spirit, and he'll be back again. And that is a part of God's story.
Hey kids, grab your crayons and let's color in today's Bible story. Print today's graph back to back and create your own Ascension Day puzzle. did Jesus send to help us? How can I share Jesus with others so that they can come to know his love too?